inside a gas station store when a man steals her car. With daughters 13-year-old Jocelyn and 6-month-old Ivy inside.
I was definitely helpless. I didn't know what to do.
As police frantically search for the stolen vehicle, Jocelyn is terrified she'll never see her mom again.
Officer, I didn't know for sure he's gonna find me.
The nightmare begins while she's feeding her baby sister in the back of the car, and suddenly a strange man hops into the driver's seat.
The door opens, the guy gets in, and at first I think it's my mom, and then I do a double take because he automatically, starts driving.
Terrified, Jocelyn screams at the car thief to stop.
I was worried he was gonna hurt us, and I was also worried that he was gonna, keep us. I was like, okay, you can have me, but not my baby sister.
She tries to negotiate with the guy. She's talking about how take me, or come take my little sister. And what that does on a deeper level, it humanizes her. So he's seeing this as a family, not just a car.
But the man ignores Jocelyn and keeps driving. Jocelyn doesn't know what to do until she notices her mother's phone is still sitting on the front passenger seat. That's when she makes a bold move.
I smashed the phone because I didn't want to have your phone. So I just dial 911, put the phone down, and I leave it there so they can listen.
Because the kidnapper never sees her grab the phone, he has no idea that now the police can hear everything. So Jocelyn starts screaming for help.
Dispatch also can immediately start working on is an emergency ping on the phone and can get location information with that.
But because she doesn't know if anyone will find them in time, Jocelyn makes another daring decision. With the kidnapper still driving, she rolls down and leans halfway out the window.
I flail my arms out and I'm hanging out of it. And I'm screaming at the top of my lungs for help.
When nobody notices her, the frantic 13-year-old quietly tries to use her own cell phone to call her dad. Thankfully, he picks up.
And she's telling me she doesn't know where she's
at. Oh my god.
And I freaked out.
Jerry doesn't know what is going on, but he immediately pulls up the shared location app on his phone to try and see exactly where his daughter is.
My one thought was getting dressed, so I just put the pinpoint on her and ran out the door.
To her dad's relief, the phone shows that Jocelyn is still in the area.
She was about a mile away from me, as far as I could see. And I just tied it up and just going, as fast as I can go.
He shouldn't even be in there.
The man still doesn't say anything, but he does do something surprising.
I think that scared him a little bit because he zoomed in the parking lot.
With no warning, the kidnapper abruptly stops the car and takes off on foot. A few minutes later, a patrol car spots the stolen vehicle.
I was sitting in the back seat of the car when the officer had received a call that they were safe, and I just remember feeling probably a million bricks taken off my shoulder. I didn't care about anything that other than that they're all in one piece.
The girls are uninjured, but Jocelyn is shaken and terrified that police won't locate the kidnapper.
What if they don't find him? It was honestly really scary.
Within 25 minutes, Jocelyn and her baby sister are reunited with their parents.
There's some crap dogs for her, and Ivy and Snoopa. That was a good moment because that she was still there and nothing happened to her.
It just felt like forever. But as soon as I saw, got close to her and saw, where she was, I couldn't have been any better. Preserving her own life plus her sister's. She took hold of the situation and proud of her.
24 hours later, someone reports a man at a bus station bragging about a carjacking and kidnapping.
The police went down there, and he was wearing the same clothes as he was wearing the day before in all the videos.
It's Jocelyn's kidnapper. He's taken into custody for questioning, but refuses to talk.
How are you? My name's Adeline. What's your name?
But then, after he's read his rights, he suddenly changes his mind.
He was just coming up up with all kinds of information, which was perfect for the case. Actually, he was the one that told on himself.
The man's name is Charles Brandon Peterson, and it turns out he's no stranger to the criminal justice system. His long list of convictions includes 16 felonies, such as theft, robbery, and assault.
And so, when I saw the violent crimes that he had been convicted of in his past, I knew then right away just how lucky Jocelyn and I were.
Police are rescuing 39-year-old Charles Peterson this morning.
Peterson is currently behind bars at the Utah State Prison for several parole violations and is still awaiting trial for the case involving Jocelyn and her baby sister.
That definitely makes me feel better, knowing that he's not still prowling around out there.
As for what caused Peterson to steal the car that day, Detective Lorkey can only speculate.
I think that he has a drug habit, and he saw it as something to maybe trade in for some drugs. I don't think he had any intention of kidnapping kids.
Whatever his intentions, she's amazed
he wanted
by how
a car.
13-year-old Jocelyn handled the horrifying ordeal.
He's lucky I wasn't in there. He's still lucky.
Jocelyn's parents couldn't agree more.
She had an amazing. She's so smart, strong for her age.
Can't believe they put him in here.
Using her instincts, she trusted herself. Awesome. You know, this is something you can't teach.
As for Jocelyn, who is now 15 years old, she says the terrifying situation.
There's two something you can teach.